This has to be one of my most favorite trends of all time. Just watching people freak out for no reason. People blow up over the littlest things and the whole encounter is caught on camera for us to enjoy and laugh at. That is some of the best entertainment the internet can give us. And for today, we are going to be expanding on what we understand as the word Karen and venturing into the male Karen. I heard that male Karens are called Kevins, but you understand exactly what I mean when I say male Karen. Hello again, most amazing top 10 family. I am your host, Chade Arena, and for today's list, we will be counting down the top 10 scary male Karens that need to be stopped. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. And you guys need to check out our new channel, Top 10 Central Dark, for the best scary reactions. Here's a clip.
I don't know. I don't trust.
What is he looking at? What is, okay, what is. Squirrel in my life.
It feels like my heart's gonna explode.
And stick around until the end of this video because I'm going to be reading out some questions from my Instagram inbox. And without taking any longer, let's get into this list. Coming in at number 10, we have male Karen sets a trap. A Karen and her male Karen husband were walking through a trail in a forest, and they thought even though it's a public trail and anyone can use it, they should be allowed to control who uses the trail. They didn't want people biking through the trail, so they put huge branches all over the trail so people coming through the trail would hit them and go flying off their bikes and possibly die. Yeah, that is a perfectly normal thing to do.
One demon down there, full pelt. You weren't paying any attention to what's going on with that. We had to get out of the way.
So what is that?
I have no idea.
No idea.
It doesn't matter what.
Later in the clip, more cyclists show up and they start giving this crazy couple hell because they all could have been seriously injured from this booby trap that they laid out on the trail. This could have led to a ton of people being in the hospital. Coming in at number 9, we have male Karen detains a minor. This male Karen starts holding a kid hostage in a store when he thinks he's filming his kid. The person filming here was just making a Snapchat. So he starts holding this kid against the wall, trying to stop him from leaving. And the only reason that this male Karen thinks that someone was trying to film his kid is because his kid was running through the store and knocking things off the shelves and being out of control. You know, if you spent more time keeping your kids under wraps in public, you wouldn't need to worry about him becoming internet famous.
Come on. We're gonna get the police on you, both of you guys.
Call the police. We didn't do anything wrong.
Security.
I will let them
search my phone. Up there.
I didn't do anything wrong.
You're not gonna film my kid. Put him on the internet. You've already admitted you did.
I mean, let's look at this from the other angle. Even if you have someone who's doing something like that, like filming your kid, you can't just grab them and hold them. Even if you think they did that thing, take a picture of them so then you can later show it to the police and also try and control your kid. Coming in at number 8, we have Thor's Hammer male Karen. Someone on Reddit wrote about how they used to be a manager at a Halloween store. We all know the vibe, something like a Spirit Halloween Supplies. Well, he was working one day and he just heard someone screaming in the store. He walked to find out what was going on and he found a grown man who was furious because he found a Thor's hammer that was for a costume and didn't have that piece of leather attached to the hilt of the hammer. He told the guy that he could grab another one that had the leather on it if he wanted and just replace the hammers, but this guy continued to scream and demanded to speak with the manager. The funny thing is, he was already speaking with the manager. Well, this male Karen slammed the hammer on the ground and it shattered and then he stormed out. The manager called the police and they had to go arrest this dude over a $12 plastic hammer. Coming in at number 7, we have male Karen comes for rent. So with the COVID-19 virus, a lot of people have had their rent frozen because it's kind of hard to pay for rent when you don't have a job because your job was decimated by the virus, and if you go to work, you could literally die. Also, if the government freezes your rent, you're allowed to miss a few payments. Well, a male Karen didn't agree with this, and he decided that he would go to his tenant's house and try and force his way into their apartment. When the tenant told him that he had to leave and he wasn't allowed to just barge into their home, he decided that he was going to put his tenant in a headlock and try and forcibly remove him from the property. The tenant's girlfriend was there and filmed this whole thing, and of course, the police arrived shortly after. This led to the landlord being arrested while screaming no as the cops took him away. Coming at number 6, we have male Karen with a baton. A male Karen waits beside a driver's car who he felt was parked too close to him. When the guy comes back to his car, he springs out with a baton in his hand ready to attack the guy. Like, what on earth are you thinking? You get to beat a man because of a bad parking job? Well, this male Karen starts threatening the driver, telling him he's going to beat the hell out of him without even explaining what's going on. The driver has to ask this male Karen like 5 times what's happening before he finally says, "It's because you don't know how to park." When the driver realizes what this is about, he calmly says, "I can move my car," and the male Karen just starts yelling at full volume, cocking back the baton like he's gonna crack the guy in the head. Eventually, the driver gets into his car and the Karen starts sitting on his back bumper so the driver can't leave. So he just turns up his music so he can't hear the guy and just waits for him to get off his car. Honestly, if this happened to me and I had enough good podcasts downloaded, I could wait there forever. Coming in at number 5, we have male Karen tries to control the air. This male Karen wants to control anything that goes in the sky, and he thinks he can come onto a public beach where there are no people and try and tell someone that they are not allowed to fly a drone. Now, I would understand if the drone was being flown over people and they didn't like the drone coming close to them, or if they were worried that the drone was taking pictures of them, but that is not the case. This one is flying over no one, and this Karen comes out and tries to shut them down.
This is a public beach.
Again, it's against FAA regulations.
There's no FAA regulations. This is unrestricted airspace.
Okay, I'll tell you what, if you don't ground them,
I am not gonna fly again. I'm not gonna.
I love how he tries to say that it's restricted airspace, like he's some sort of army commander. Like, bro, there's nothing going on here where you need to use the words restricted airspace. And if you were to check out the whole clip, the guy flying the drone has already inspected to see if he was allowed to fly the drone. And guess what? He is. This male Karen thinks he can command the skies like he's Zeus himself. Coming in at number 4, we have male Karen hates music. There is a band performing in the streets, and they are legally allowed to do so. They have all the right permits and everything, but this male Karen thinks that because he doesn't like the music, he can shut the whole thing down. There's a massive crowd around this band and everyone is loving the music, and then he comes up and starts unplugging their instruments. Luckily, these musicians are very cool and politely ask him to leave. He doesn't leave, and then the crowd starts to turn on him. They're about to tear this dude apart, and then the police arrive and stop everyone from ending this dude, and they also remove the male Karen. This guy was so lucky, because most musicians would cave your head in for touching their stuff, and if it wasn't gonna be them, the crowd was seconds away from dragging this man through the streets. Coming in at number 3, we have phone call male Karen. A customer service rep is trying to talk to a guy on the phone, but the guy on the phone goes full male Karen and loses his mind. The guy is just trying to figure out what's wrong, and he won't even let the customer service rep speak. I don't know how you're supposed to get any help from a person who's talking to you if they can't get a word in.
Hey man,
why should I pay money to your company, sir, when you can't do your job? When you abuse people, it's part of your job, sir?
All right, man.
Also, it's not good to argue with people on the phone because they can just hang up on you and they are for sure laughing at you on the other end. You're never going to get what you want when you're talking to people like this. Coming in at number 2, we have male Karen wants ID. A male Karen stops a truck in his neighborhood because he said he heard a loud noise. The dudes in the truck start filming him because he blocks their way, and then he starts talking to them about how he wanted to see identification.
No, I was asking for identification. Identification.
But who are you though? Are you the police?
I'm not.
So why do I have to identify myself to you?
I don't know if this guy knows how the world works, but you don't have to present ID to every person who asks you what you're doing when you're working. Do you know how much longer that would make your work day? Especially when you're not a cop. You didn't hire these people, dude. You're not paying them. So the last person they have to answer to is some rando who comes up to them in the street. I think they're just going to keep working and ignore Mr. Blockwatch. And coming in at number 1, we have Douglas Levison, aka the trumpet fight guy. This is maybe the most famous male Karen of all time. This guy goes up to a random guy playing the trumpet outside and starts screaming at him while threatening to swing his bag of what looks like garbage at him. There is so much strange about this video. The guy is so strange looking, and he goes on forever about how much he hates this guy for playing the trumpet. The video is like 3 minutes long, and it's just David going on and on and on and on about how much he hates this guy. He's literally so mad.
Maybe everybody else wants to enjoy the peace and quiet. This is one of the most important places in all of North America. Who are you? Who are you? You miserable. miserable, presumptuous, no talent!
Alright everyone, that is all we have for you for today's video, and as promised, we are going to be answering some questions from my Instagram inbox. Kawika13 wrote in and asked, do you ever have dark days? And the truth is, yeah, we all have dark days. I don't think mine are very often because I really do a lot to make myself feel good and take care of my mental health. I make sure I'm eating healthy and working out and getting good sleep. Honestly, if you work on those three things, it won't fix all of your problems, but you will be surprised how much better you feel every day. Our next question comes from Playful Strings, who wrote in and asked, if you could change your name, what would it be and why? Honestly, I love my name and I don't think I would ever change it, but if I had to, I would probably go with something insane like Z-Morph the Destroyer. Like, I would have a full title as my name because that is very cool and it commands respect. And finally, our last question comes from HBKATrain220, who wrote in and asked, what is your favorite animal? And that is a very tough question. There are so many cool ones. I like the octopus a lot because it's super smart and it's cool as hell. It has all those tentacles and camouflage. Bears are dope because they get to sleep for so long, like half the year they just sleep and they come out and eat a bunch and then they have sex and they go back to bed. But I would also put monkeys high on the list because they are probably the funniest animal of all time. All right, everyone, that is completely it. Thank you all so much for tuning in. As always, I would love it if you could like, comment, subscribe, and hit the little notification bell. Until next time, I have been your host, Jade Arena, and watch out for those male Karens, man. Bye.